Hi, I am Bobby, and this is my report on static and kinetic friction for Flippin' Physics. Friction is a force that tries to prevent two surfaces from sliding relative to one another. For example, this wooden block on a ramp is not sliding down the ramp because there is a force of friction acting up the ramp to prevent it from sliding down the ramp. However, if the block is sliding down the ramp, there is still a force of friction acting up the ramp that resists the sliding of the block. But
what is friction?
You ask. Friction is caused by two surfaces rubbing against one another. It may not look like it on a macroscopic scale. However, when we take a closer look and view the surfaces of the wooden block and the ramp on a microscopic scale, we see the two surfaces are actually rough and have hills and valleys. It is the interaction of the hills and valleys of the two surfaces that causes the force of friction. If we push down on the wooden block, we increase the amount the hills and valleys interact, which increases the force of friction. Also, the rougher the surfaces, the more the hills and valleys interact with one another, and therefore the larger the force of friction. Oh, and notice the symbol for the force of friction is capital F with a subscript of F, and the force of friction is a vector, and therefore has both
magnitude and direction.
There are two different kinds of friction, static and kinetic. The word static means lacking in movement, action, or change, and therefore static friction is when the two surfaces causing the friction are not moving relative to one another. The word kinetic means of relating to or resulting from motion, and therefore kinetic friction is when the two surfaces causing the friction are moving relative to one another.
Okay, so when the two surfaces are not sliding relative to one another, it is static friction. And when the two surfaces are sliding relative to one another, then it is kinetic friction, right?
That is correct. Friction typically does not depend on surface area. In other words, because these two blocks are equal in mass, even though the top block has a larger contact surface area, they will have the same force of static friction. This is because pressure, which equals force divided by area, will decrease proportionally as the contact surface area increases, and the force of static friction will remain the same.
Oh, right, that makes sense. So this one, which has a larger contact surface area, has a smaller pressure, and therefore the force of friction in both cases will be the same.
Now, let's talk about the direction of the force of friction. There are three things you should know about the direction of the force of friction. First, the force of friction is always parallel to the interacting surfaces. Therefore, in this case, the force of friction could be up or down the incline. Second, the force of friction always opposes sliding or opposes motion.
Hold up, but the block isn't sliding in this particular case.
This is true. However, in the absence of friction, the block would slide down the incline. Therefore, the force of friction opposes this motion and is therefore up the incline. Third, the force of friction is independent of the direction of the force applied. Often people think the force of friction is opposite the direction of the force applied. However, that is not true. You can see there is no force applied in this free body diagram. Therefore, the direction of the force of friction is definitely independent of the direction of the force applied. Again, the direction of the force of friction is always parallel to the surfaces, opposes the sliding motion of the two surfaces relative to one another, and is independent of the direction of the force applied. Thank you very much for learning with me today.
I enjoyed learning with you.